Pumpkin Spice.
Hello, this is Trevor Jones with Crypto Disruption, and you're listening to Milk on CoinSpice.
CoinSpice.io. Edward Kelso from CoinSpice.
After the third year of being rejected, I said, screw this. You know, I snuck into the Royal Scottish Academy Open Exhibition the day before the Open, before the big, you know, gala event. I'm not going to say how because it can get into trouble. But I took photographs of all the artwork on the walls. There's about 400 contemporary artists that were accepted. And I managed to augment. I went home that night and spent all night long augmenting 60 of them. With my work, so you could scan the works. Well, what happened? I would actually augment all of them, but I ran out of my own images. But then I counterfeited 30 tickets to the opening night. You know, it's all kind of fancy dress, black tie, kilts.
Uh-huh.
And I invited 30 of my closest friends to come in. They had my app, and they were scanning all the artworks on the walls, and I was filming it all. And the responses were brilliant, you know, from visitors to a lot of the other artists there, you know, good and bad. So you scan the painting, and actually it was my painting on the wall inside that frame with a link to my website, a link to my Facebook page. And I was actually going to put a link to a shopping cart. You could purchase my painting through their painting.
Yeah.
And I thought, oh God, you know, this is starting to cross some lines here legally, and I might get sued. So I took that one down, but the response was hilarious. I mean, I was shitting myself at first. You know, the next day I got emails from some fairly important artists in Scotland. One was like the president of Visual Arts Scotland at the time. And he just started off with like, well, that's, you know, it's some interesting technology you're using, Trevor. I can see how it could be used, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. However, and then he just went on this long rant about me completely disrespecting 188-year-old tradition of the Royal Scottish Academy, disrespecting the artist, disrespecting the establishment. And it's like, you know, so that it was at that point that I thought, after I got over the initial fear of, you know, I'm not going to jail, I'm not getting sued, I thought, This is I'm onto something here. I'm ruffling some feathers. I'm shaking some things up, and this is what, you know, good art should do.
Seriously, and the video again. I'll embed in our show notes page. It's just badass. And we'll get into the specifics here. But you actually have an app on both Google Play and the iStore, right?
iStore. Yeah.
The Creative Muse, but it's without that second E?
Yes, so Creative V and then on to M-U-S-E, Creative Muse.
Okay, so C-R-E-A-T-I-V-M-U-S-E. And you download his app, and you go to these these beautiful paintings that are, you know, hundreds of years old, and they you know, you can appreciate them for themselves, and then you kind of hold up his app, and your phone scans it, and all of a sudden it turns into fucking Brian Armstrong giving you a dissertation here on Bitcoin or whatever. It's just an amazing idea. When I saw it, I was just like, what? It's crazy. And I remember hitting you up.
Anyone can go into the National Portrait Gallery now scan the portraits of the Scottish elite, the kings, the queens, the philosophers, the entrepreneurs, you know, over the last, you know, few hundred years. And they can scan, like, you know, Robbie Burns, you know, the most famous Scot of them all. And he morphs into Roger Ver talking about...
Oh, that blew me away. That blew me away. That you found that blew me away. Because Burns and Ver actually look alike.
They do. It was crazy. It was, I mean, I was, everybody sees that and go like, but they look like they could actually be brothers.
it's just so wild. But anyway, I kind of wonder when art, I guess it's true with, you know, punk rock or with really anything that becomes established. I think they forget you know, kind of the roots. I mean, I don't know you personally, but artists are usually nuts, man. They're crazy. They do wild, fun things. That's the whole entire point of being an artist, man. I mean, I'm trying to think of an example where an artist is not, you know, just balls out. The ones that I love anyway, just going out and doing their own thing. So, well, just great on you for doing that. Anyway, you've got to see this video. He goes and he sneaks in and he gets all the paintings that he can. Like you said, he describes, he goes back and augments them, and then it turns into this experience. It's a totally new way to experience art, and in particular crypto. So now you have
turned the National Crypto Gallery into a crypto resource center for anybody who wants to use. And you can come in, scan the works. There's 28 to 30 paintings on the walls, and the most well-known, established, spectacular paintings in the National Portrait Gallery, and find out all about crypto.
Coin Spice.